Hello everyone, I hope everybody's having a wonderful day, and on this video I'm going to show you guys how I customize this secretary. I'm going to be customizing this old secretary desk. This one has a lot of issues. It wasn't taken care of, but it was highly used. I'm going to have to fix a lot of issues. The back of it's coming off. The top is also kind of messed up. It's kind of broken right there. The glass was missing, but luckily they kept those. So I'll be able to get some new glass for it, put those back on. It's a very beautiful piece. I was happy to find it so I could restore it and give it a whole new life. I just finished taking it completely apart. It's one of the things I like to do if I'm going to work on a piece that has a lot of damage, a lot of issues. I would rather take it all the way down if I can, reinforce everything, fix all the issues, and start over. Okay, after further inspection of these legs, I decided to flip the secretary upside down and noticed that front leg was completely loose, so was the back leg. This one was good, and this piece was just loose, so I'm going to re-glue this area, retighten it, just retighten this one just a little bit, re-glue these areas right here, and then just get it ready, let them dry. And then fix this little area right here. And then after it's completely dry, then I'll flip it back over and start sanding. Now on this one, being that I had to take it completely apart, I was going to take full advantage and customize this in a special way. This one is going to be painted. Now my process on these mahogany pieces is to sand as much as the original finish off. And as you can tell, it's almost back to the bare wood. One of the drawers was taken down because all the original finish was completely falling off. The rest of it was okay, so I just had to smooth it all out. Hello everyone, today is day two of the secretary project. Now, today I will be smoothing out the paint, and for that, I like using these surf prep sanding sponges. This one in a fine, or this is a super fine. I mostly like using these to smooth out the paint, because after you spray, a lot of times it's not as smooth as it should be. So I just like going over it, making it as smooth as possible. Then after that, I will be using the 120 grit sandpaper to distress all the little edges. Now that the paint distressing process is done, we're going to move into the stain process. So on this one, I decided to go with Minwax Red Mahogany liquid stain. On this one, I didn't want to use a gel stain because of the different types of mahogany wood that I will be staining. And I like using it because it gives me a little better coverage on different types of wood, especially on one certain piece. Now, another thing I like to do is I like to prep correctly. I like to take my time, cover all the spots that I do not want stain to go on, so I don't have to go back and clean those areas. And at the end, it speeds up the process, but it also makes it a little bit easier for cleanup. Now, I will be starting with this. One thing, another thing I like to point out is I like using these foam brushes to apply the stain. On this one, I'm going to apply it. Then I'm going to see how much it penetrates to see if it gives me the desired color or if I'm going to wipe away the excess. But here's my process.
Hello everyone, today is the last day of the secretary project. Today I will be sealing it with polyurethane, and this is the one I like to use.
I like using this Veritame Ultimate polyurethane. On this secretary I'll be using satin. On other ones I also like using matte. And now that it's all clean, sand it, distressed. Now we'll just have to seal it.